Hello, I asked a mainstream Orthodox priest to respond to Father Maximus Moretta's article called Why the True Orthodox Are Truly Orthodox. The relevant part of the priest's response is as follows. Frankly, I am not sure what to say about this article. Let me explain. In my view, the entire ecclesiological foundation of the discussion is flawed, as well as the simple issue of the calendar. 1. The church is the city church, the local church, the whole church. It is governed by a first presbyter, bishop, who in unity with the presbyter makes disciplinary decision, including on such matters as the calendar, which, if not clearly against revealed commandments, are fully binding. 2. Now, the problem that we have seen in history is when two bishops disagree. For instance, Cyprian and Stephen of Rome. It seems clear to me that both were right and both were wrong. They were each in their right to enforce a particular discipline in and for their church, but it was a problem that the two policies were not in sync. 3. The Quarto Deciman controversy is interesting because it is an example of the above. There were two disciplines, and it was fine as long as the two bishops did not come into open conflict over their preference. Neither practice was heretical, and so it was fine to observe Pascha on either date. Eventually, these churches lost their distinctive Hebrew traits and agreed to adopt the more mainstream calendar for the sake of peace. When these bishops approved the Sunday date for their churches, the Quarto Decimans became a different animal, so to speak. 4. I have already explained why I think the new calendar is actually better and more biblical than the old, but again, the local bishop, as head of the church, can decide. Ideally, there will be harmony among the bishops, if only an agreement to disagree. The problem with the old calendar's movement is not only a rejection of the necessary change, but a rejection of the authority of the bishop to exercise his divine authority in the church. Now, there are mechanisms by which an isolated bishop can be overruled or removed by the presbytery, by several neighboring bishops, by the full regional synod. I hope that the above is somewhat helpful regarding the article.